The push for historic immigration reform took a significant step forward. The Senate approved the biggest overhaul of immigration laws in decades by a vote of 68 to 32. 14 Republicans joined every Democrat in voting yes. The bill provides a pathway to citizenship for millions of undocumented immigrants. It also calls for a major security surge at the border. The legislation faces an uncertain future, though, in the House, but senators who led the push for reform are satisfied with their part of the job.
The great thing about America is we take anyone and everyone and say you can be an American, and they want to be Americans. It's a beautiful thing, and we're on a journey to ensure that that will happen for generations to come.
I like the fact that people want to become part of America because it's an idea that nobody owns. Bob Menendez doesn't own it. Lindsey Graham doesn't own it. It's not owned by religion, any particular group. It's an idea that a lot of people buy into. We just ask one simple thing. Do it legally. And I think we've created a way to solve illegal immigration.
Well, joining us is Sungmin Kim, congressional reporter for Politico. Sungmin, thanks for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
So we just heard a little bit from a couple of members of the Gang of Eight. The legislation that ended up passing in the Senate was a little different than what they had originally put together. Can you give us some of the highlights?
That's exactly right. The biggest, the most major change from what they originally put out back in April to what passed the House passed the Senate yesterday is this almost unprecedented surge in border security along the U.S.-Mexico border. Many Republicans in the Senate had made it very clear they could not support this bill unless they were confident that the border would be secured and that we wouldn't have this, you know, next wave of illegal immigration like what happened after the 1986 law was enacted. So what they did, so the biggest change is the so-called border surge. It was written by two Republicans, not in the Gang of Eight, but it dedicates, you know, almost $40 billion to new border patrol agents, new technology along the border, and a requirement to finish 700 miles of fencing along the U.S.-Mexico boundary. So that's the biggest change from what the Gang of Eight released back in April.
The Gang of Eight, they were hoping for 70 votes. They got 68, which is pretty close. 14 Republicans voted yes. One Republican voted yes by mistake and then had to reverse his vote. A little comic relief that was probably needed at the time, but they got 14
exactly.
Republicans. What about the rest of the Republicans? What is it that they don't like about this legislation?
It's primarily border security. They're saying, you know, they are just not confident that they do it. Goes far enough to make sure that the border is properly secured, and not only in terms of the actual border, but whether there's going to be enough what we call interior enforcement, you know, whether it's a tough E-Verify program, workplace verification for all employers in the United States, and other provisions as well. I think that a lot of Republicans were concerned that a lot of the legalization for millions of undocumented immigrants happens before a lot of these major security measures take place. So that was their biggest concern.
How about the White House? How did the White House react?
They were very happy. I mean, they've made it clear all along, ever since the Gang of Eight released their, you know, so-called principles back in January, from when the bill was released and until now. This is not the bill that the White House would have written. It's significantly much more emphasizing on the border security part than I'm sure they would like. And it's much tougher on that pathway to citizenship for millions. But they said, you know, this is a great accomplishment, that they're now putting that pressure on the Republican-led House to act on immigration reform and hopefully get something signed into law this year.
All right, that is the next step now, the House. What are the odds that the success of the bill in the Senate will have some sort of influence on lawmakers in the House?
It's very small. In terms of them actually taking up the Senate bill and passing it, it's almost neck to zero at this point. Leadership in the House, Speaker John Boehner has made it repeatedly clear, and he made clear again yesterday when the Senate was on the verge of passing this historic legislation that, look, you know, we're going to have our own way in the House. It's not going to be the Senate bill. It's going to look different than the Senate bill. Right now, the proper committees in the House are approaching it differently than what the Senate has. So we'll see if there's going to be something in the next couple couple of months that where the House and Senate can negotiate, a compromise bill in conference, but that's still yet to be seen.
Is there any indication as to what changes would have to occur to make this bill more palatable to the House? Is it back to security and securing the border and ensuring that we don't have more illegal immigrants coming to the country?
I think that's exactly right. I think that they're going to want more security measures. That this so-called border surge was a good start for them, but they're still concerned that that doesn't go far enough. They're still looking at trying to look for a solution for some sort of pathway to what they call a pathway to status. A lot of them aren't too keen on the pathway to citizenship that's in the Senate bill, which Democrats and many Republicans say it has to be a part of any comprehensive immigration reform effort. So there are a lot of places in differing points between the two chambers, and it's yet to be seen how they're going to be reconciled.
Sungmin Kim, congressional reporter for Politico, thanks a lot.
Thanks for having me.